Alright, good morning everyone. It is Thursday, August 26th. Getting ready to head on over to the boss's house. Get some readouts from a home inspector. So I guess the lowdown is what he told me. There was an inspection done. This house in Riverbend. Home inspector came there and you know, he said he was only getting a 10 degree split. Well, these home inspectors, you know, they use their little laser designated dialer thingamabobs, you know, super inaccurate, you know, just kind of garbage. Like, we got a Fluke IR meter, you know, at the shop that I trust pretty well, but even still, like, you know, I have mine. And I just don't feel like it's really that accurate. It's just like for a quick recognition, you know, this is an estimate temperature. They're not good for like exact temperatures, I don't think, anyways. But he's saying it's getting a 10 degree split. So something kind of might not be going on too well. Maybe a heat strip is stuck on. Maybe we're low on refrigerant. Maybe we have a huge gaping hole where the return should be. Or maybe we just have, you know, it's just a kind of like a crap unit. Who knows? It's hard to say until we get there. But yeah, so I'm sure we can get it figured out and working again. Hopefully it's not anything too crazy or too extreme. But yeah, so we're getting ready to head there and pick up some of this paperwork. And then we'll head on to the lady's house up the street. Not too far up in front of us in River Bend, maybe another half mile or so. And then I got another inspection today in Minnesota Beach in a condo. That's at 12. And then I got that board for the train. I don't know if you guys have seen it, but there was that train with the two compressors. Got that board, so we'll see if that, you know, helps it out. I'm pretty sure it is the board. I sure hope it's the board. But we're getting ready to, this light ever turns green. This is like the very longest light. And right here by the school. So it takes forever. But alright, enough chit chat. I'll let you back in when we get there. Well, we're here and I thought it would have been vacant, so we got homeowners. They're not always the happiest when they're told something's wrong with their units. I'm gonna kind of back up, give them a way out if they need to get out because it loops around. So, not sure how much I can film here, but we're gonna do it anyways, and we're gonna get her done. In this little carpeted room, where the unit is. Ow. Hopefully I don't go through this floor. Try to move this back a little bit for me. A little bit easier. Vent before the trap. Okay. Put our probe here. Put our probe in there. It's a 10 4-ton. It's a 4-ton 13-seer. Outside has a float switch. We're gonna check the function of this float. Just take it loose off of here. Flip it upside down. looks like they have it to kill the condenser. There it goes. You can hear it feeding back. So float switch is good to go. Alrighty. Sounds good. Piston up here is 78. Usually they say what type of piston they are.
Okay, 90.
What was that?
You need to get the thermostat.
We're just going to cut it down really low for me so it will run. Carpet up there too. Maybe it's like another added layer of insulation or something. So we're gonna try to get out of there without dying. Okay, so I've got the one in return right here coming off the right at the back. And I got it here. The supply coming right out, so pretty close. I'm gonna go ahead and hook these up. Dehumidifying a lot. And it was already like 73 in here, 72. Slowly coming up. Let's go put our gauges on it. Okay, so we just looked at both the returns. Got one there. The company comes out here and changes the filters every 6 months. Don't look dirty. I would prefer them maybe every 3 months, but it doesn't look bad. It's very well kept. Doesn't look like any animals, so it shouldn't be much dust or anything like that. So it should be fine. We got our probes up there. This is like a bonus. It's not zoned, but he did add a return up here. And there is a thermometer. 63% humidity up here. A little bit higher than I was hoping, but it's not zoned. So you can get what you get, you got. But there is a little return there. And this is just access to some duct and everything. It's gonna be like having to replace. Alright, so far so good.
Alright.
We're gonna check this outdoor system out. It's a nice place over here. On the water. Good thing they angled it towards me. It's always nice. It's like some people put these in and then they angle it away from you. It's like, man, you're on a stand, think about it. So that's where our line set's going. Nice, good wrap. You usually see this on refrigeration equipment, so it's good. We got a 13 sear, 4 ton, 2010 model. This is a 410A. It's ring off. So we'll get the S-Man's, sand her down a little bit. Try not to tear this up too much. Should be alright. But yeah, let me go get those and we'll get this thing rolling. Alright, so we're hooked up. It's not looking too bad to me. I just went into this guy's crawl space. He wanted to know if we did dehumidifier. He said he had some water issues. Got a vapor barrier under there. It's got a little bit of water here and there. I mean, nothing too extreme. You know, it's just like every other house, you know. A lot of water up under these houses. So it's not too terribly bad. Let's change our design target. Let's get our actual telling us our target should be 13. And we're sitting at 2 with a 10 degree set point. Okay, about to pop this off and let's check it out. So, pull the death door off. Look at here, nothing. No charging information at all. So I'm gonna look this up on my East Coast app and see if I can find out some charging info about this, because I'm not finding any. But I want to say, you know, it's wanting, if it is TXV, which I doubt, piston, it's 10 dread on the money. But let me see what I can find. Alright, after digging around for a little bit, I downloaded the app. I got it on this phone, but I'm filming with this phone, so I downloaded it on my iPhone. And got this whole slew of technical data to go through for cooling, expanded performance data, blah 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 blah. Long story short, I found it. So it's wanting a 2 degree superheat for the temperature inside as far as the return temperature. Oh, no, nothing's connected. So as far as the wet bulb goes and the outdoor, it's wanting 2. So it's saying we might not be right, but according to the manufacturer's data, we are right on the money. So I think we're gonna be concluded here. I'm gonna have to go back up in there and get my probes. Can't forget those, because they're too expensive to leave around. And then I guess we're going to go down there and put that. So it's draining pretty well. So it is doing that good. But he says he has some company that comes out here and works on this, so we are getting a lot of back feed from it blowing up there. We can feel it back there behind it. Other than that, it's looking good. Possibly get another 10 years out of her. And that's it, another day in the life of a HVAC tech. So this one's looking good over here. I did talk to him about that crawl space, if he wants to go out and get a dehumidifier, he can. I told him, like, look man, you know, it's like every other place, there's water under it no matter what. I mean, it's really hard to have, I mean, you can get them dry, you spend lots of money, but I was like, dude, you could just go to Lowe's, get you a dehumidifier for like $400 or $500, hang it up, pipe it out, and you don't have to worry about it. You know, get you some foam, close these up if you want to, or you can get us, do it, you know, $25, $100, $3,000, and we'll do, you know, we'll do it all for you. I mean, we'll do it all right, you know, but it's just, you know, you want to throw that much money into it, if you want to, we'll do it. But I try to look out for people, you know. I'm not trying to get them to just throw their wallet at everything all the time. You know, I'm gonna be glad to do it, but, you know, like to keep your, like you to save your money. But yep, like I said once before, it's a great day in the life of an HVAC technician, and we'll see you on the next one. Alright, so another one that is done. We got the goods, got the details. You know, it's working good. Like I said, I hate those little IR thermometers, you know. It's an estimate. And his returns were like literally 12, 13 feet up. So I mean, it's like, dude, come on. You really think this is going to be any kind of accurate? And the supplies are way up in there. The only way I got the accuracy of what I did is because I put it right in the return and right in the supply, as close as I could to the unit. But yeah, it's doing all right. You know, hopefully the buyers can get another 10 years or so out of it, maybe a little bit longer. It is a 2010, so it's not too old, but you know, it's what is it, 11 years old, getting ready to be 12 years old. So, you know, it's got a little bit of age, not too much, you know. He should be able to get some life out of it. The buyers, he or she, whoever, should be able to get some more life out of it. So, we're getting ready to, not sure where we're getting ready to go next, as far as, I got this train board, that good old train, and we might be getting ready to go do that now.